The picture's telling the story on every face. Unbelievable scenes at Lord's. It's the final over of the match. It'll be bowled by Stuart Broad. Every fielder is around the bat. That's down the leg side, and he's gloved it. He's gloved it. He hasn't even turned to wait for the umpire. Nine down and five balls remaining. It couldn't be tighter. It couldn't be more tense.
And the change works for England. Brilliant from Stuart Broad. Another good catch for Matt Prior. Harath walks straight off. Cross seamer from Broad. Really good catch from Matthew Prior. He's had an excellent match. Harath goes for one. Sri Lanka nine down. Five balls remaining.
Well, look at this picture. This is fascinating. A replay, and it appears that the bottom hand is off the bat. And had Ranganathan reviewed that, he would not have been given out after review, because that hand is off the bat.
Well, he's got an average of five, and the fact that he doesn't have a bat sponsor, no stickers on there, suggests to me that he isn't that good.
Arun Pradeep with his heart pumping. Oh, we'll sprint in here, expect it full and straight. Whoa, and he unsettles him with a bumper first up. He missed it. The crowd thought he nicked it.
Well, I reckon a more qualified right-hander might have nicked it, because it's an absolute beauty. On and around the off stump. Look at the bounce, seam movement.
It's the ball, and well played. Well played, all credit. Arun Pradeep in behind it, watched it, didn't panic. Two balls remain. England need one wicket.
I'll tell you what, it's pretty gloomy out there. It's pretty gloomy for the Sri Lankan coach, Marvin Attapattu, as well. He can't even watch.
That's the ball. That's the ball! That's the test match! And that's the review.
Well, I think he's inside edge this. Straight away, he's reviewed it. England are celebrating. I'm pretty sure there's a big inside edge.
This will be the one. Oh, he's hit it. Oh, he's hit it. Which, folks, leaves us with one ball in the test match and one wicket to take.
I can't take any more of this. Oh, this is remarkable. It really is.
There's confirmation, it's not out. This is just fantastic. How do you explain this to people? 5 days this match has gone on for. It's come down to the very last ball. It's a good ball, and it doesn't carry the slip. And the match is drawn, and the disbelief is apparent. The anti-climax sensed by the England players. The immense relief from the Sri Lankan changing room. The picture's telling the story on every face. Unbelievable scenes at Lord's. Really, it's hard to tell such a story, because a card gives you some facts and some figures, but it gives you nothing of the emotion, or as Michael Vaughan said, of the drama. 201 for 9. Kumar Sangakkara with 61 led the way there. We mustn't ignore the man just above him in that list, Kaushal Silva. What a performance from him in both innings of this match. When Sangakkara went, you felt the door was open. Could England slam it shut? Not quite is the answer to that question. Angelo Matthews hung on in there and defied that England attack. 4 wickets for James Anderson, 3 for Stuart Broad, and 2 for Chris Jordan. Everybody pulled everything out, all the stops, and it wasn't quite enough in the end for England to manage to win the test match. Well done, Sri Lanka. They have such courage and they have such conviction. They're so proud of their island. They play for it, they play for their people, and they've managed to pull off a brilliant thing here at Lord's. They've been outplayed for the main part of this test match, but they hung on and they go to Headingley with the series still level.